It's Friday, February the 18th. This is the Green Bar Valley Church of the Nazarene with your daily devotion. Hello and welcome. Today we read from the book of 2 Peter, chapter 3, verses 1 through 9. Here's the word of the Lord. Dear friends, this is now my second letter to you. I have written both of them as reminders to stimulate you to wholesome thinking. I want you to recall the words spoken in the past by the holy prophets and the command given by our Lord and Savior through your apostles. Above all, you must understand that in the last days scoffers will come, scoffing and following their own evil desires. They will say, "Where is this coming he promised?" Ever since our ancestors died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. But they deliberately forget that long ago, by God's words, the heavens came into being and the earth was formed out of water and by water. By these waters also the world of that time was deluged and destroyed. By the same word, the present heavens and earth are reserved for fire, by being kept for the day of judgment and destruction of the ungodly. But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is like a day. The Lord is not slow in keeping his promises, as some understand slowness. Instead, he is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone coming to repentance. And that is the word of the Lord. The article today, by Lorda Ruiz is "Remember What the Lord Has Done." Our memories are built up with the stories and things we keep repeating over and over. At the dinner table, we repeat stories to affirm the memories we have. We don't want to forget our stories because they remind us of who we are. The younger ones will remember every detail, but as you grow old, you will forget. My grandmother recited the Psalms by memory, and she stayed committed to repeating them until the day she died. My mother-in-law has dementia, but she still sings that one song that she can remember over and over. Throughout the story of the Israelites, we see that they forgot what the Lord did for them. Sadly, the prophecies weren't enough. The psalms they sung weren't enough. The everyday reading wasn't enough. What do we need to do? Have conversations at the dinner table about your faith. Remember from where the Lord rescued you. Memorize the scriptures. Stay connected with those who affirm your memories and develop a longing desire for remembering what the Lord has done for you. The hymn today is titled "May the Mind of Christ, My Savior" by Kate B. Wilkinson. May the mind of Christ, my Savior, live in me from day to day. By his love and power controlling all I do and say, looking only unto Jesus as I onward go. And from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verse 9. You who bring good news to Zion, go up on a high mountain. You who bring good news to Jerusalem, lift up your voice with a shout. Lift it up. Do not be afraid. Say to the towns of Judah, here is your God. And that's your daily devotion for Friday, February the 18th. Have a blessed day.